Hey guys, it's 404, and we're back with some more Tales of Monkey Island. This part, we're going to be starting the third chapter, The Lair of the Leviathan. So, let's start a new game.
It is said that we are never so vulnerable than when we trust. But paradoxically, if we cannot trust, neither can we find our heart's desire. Guybrush Threepwood, trusting in his voodoo spell, unleashes
with the tarot cards again.
Caribbean. He escapes from Flotsam Island to pursue his wife Elaine and to find a cure to the pox that infects them both. On the Jerkbait Islands, Guybrush finds Elaine together with his arch-enemy, LeChuck.
She's just recounting what's happened in the past couple of chapters.
Guybrush trusts his wife with
so if this is your first part of my videos, then go watch them first.
Hunted by the
I don't know why you jump in halfway through it. Must right his wrong by
finding La Esponja Grande.
That's quite cool, how the hair and the dagger.
For the pox is transforming the seas into
like
a treacherous beast. And the beast is hungry.
Oh my god.
I don't believe it.
We get to see this again.
Believe it, sister. Wait, believe what?
We're gonna need a bigger boat. Nom 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 nom. Right, we're still alive. It's good to know.
Guybrush, I'm taking you in.
Really?
I'm sorry, I'm inside a manatee at the moment. Look behind you.
Oh, I've heard that
three-headed
one.
Three-headed monkey? No. That's what you get.
Well, Tunter, walked the body bounty huntress right into a trap.
You have to admire her stick-to-itiveness.
She's out cold.
Good. We need to get back on the track to finding La Esponja Grande. I'm gonna go find a way out of here. Preferably through the front door. Not the, service entrance.
I'll keep an eye on Miss Lafley.
I bet you,
you
will.
Sisters, I'll give her the old scurvy button.
I don't wanna know.
Oh my god, look at that rape face Winslow's pulling. God damn, Winslow, you're dark. That's dark, Winslow. Just look at that face.
Don't worry, sir. I've got my eye on Miss Lafley.
I bet you have.
She's out cold, sir.
Right. What's over here? Oh.
An encampment.
Someone really in here alive. Well, I guess we're in here alive.
Excuse me?
Kind of makes sense.
What is this? An adventurer from the outside. Who
are
you?
I'm Guybrush Threepwood.
Coronado de Cava.
That's Coronado de Cava.
De Cava, I've been looking for you. What are you doing in here?
I'm on my way to a very important artifact to be acquired for a very important woman.
I hate to be the one to break this to you, but you're stuck inside of an overgrown sea mammal.
I'm quite sure he would be aware of that.
I'm not stuck. It's all part of the plan of the ocean gods. The mouth of the manatee leads me to the artifact. The seahorses led the mouth to me. Just as I freed myself from the brig of Fat Island by bribing the guard for his bootlegs, stringing him up with a pulley fashioned from a stale scone, and then growing at my toenails over the course of a year in order to carefully carve them into a lock-picking kit, I will walk out of this beast when the time is right.
And when is that? I'm on a bit of a timetable.
When we arrive at the sacred manatee mating grounds.
Oh boy.
Gross. You made a lock-picking kit out of your toenails?
You made a lock-picking kit out of toenails?
Stop stealing my lines, Guybrush. God
damn. You didn't try the tempt the guard dog with a bone trick?
Bah, that's for amateurs.
How long have you been in here?
How long have you been in here?
Years! This journey has been even longer than expected, but the exploration is fraught with unforeseen hurdles yearning to be overcome.
Right. So, I have this locket I'm supposed to give to you.
Oh my! I haven't seen this locket for some years. She's just as I remember. Where did you... What is this?
Treepwood.
Really?
Yikes.
Well done. You have found Coronado de Cava.
She's lost a bit of weight and grown a bit of facial hair.
De Cava and his crew will prove indispensable on your quest. And while the pox spreads with every passing moment, you must tread lightly, Guybrush. Years of searching for the sponge have made De Cava unstable. He was always a bit of a sensitive soul, so please, I implore you, do not mention me. Do not mention La Esponja. And whatever you do, do not tell him where you acquired his locket.
Right,
okay.
Who
sent you?
Oh dear,
what
questioning. Panic. Really, Guybrush?
The little lady gave me the locket and told me to find you so I could track down La Esponja Grande for her so we can cure...
God damn it, Guybrush.
Me dio! That two-timing soothsaying strumpet!
Huh?
La Esponja is to be mine to give to her as a gargantuan absorbent symbol of my fiery passion!
Okay.
For 2 seconds and she's making time with a prepubescent picarone!
Hey, not prepubescent.
No, no, it's not like that.
Got a beard. Check out the beard.
We're hardly even friends.
It's a sexy beard.
A friend who she gives an invaluable sentimental locket!
Yeah.
I bet she never sends you on any quests either.
No. I mean, from time to time she tells me what to do and where to go with little or no context,
but... Sounds like a quest. Me quests? I thought I was a special. Has she ever made you a voodoo doll?
No.
I don't believe you. Have you held her in your arms?
No. No.
No. I'm married. Look.
I don't see
Look,
a ring,
a hook.
Senior Liebrush.
Ooh, burn.
With my other hand.
See that pun? Liebrush? Guybrush?
Not after the voodoo lady's heart or
Quick
La Esponja Grande.
Then why are you here?
Vacation.
Is that so?
Yeah.
Yes. Honeymooning, in fact.
With your invisible wife?
My very real wife. Let me just go get her.
I shall await her alleged arrival with tantalizing disbelief.
I smell hijinks. Winslow! Winslow! Pretend to be my wife.
Winslow, I need to revive Morgan and present her to De Cava as my fake wife.
Oh, that would work too.
That reminds me of the time
when... Now, Winslow, De Cava's crazy.
You're out of your element, Winslow.
I will.
You're out
I'm
of your
well
element.
I'm trained in naval first aid. Do as I say. First things first. Take her pulse and see if she's alive.
What? She might
yeah,
be
we
dead?
Have we have to take it anally.
Her
when
list,
that's temperature. We need to take her temperature as well. Let's get those pants off. No? Fine. Rest. We'll do it the old-fashioned way.
Very good.
Her pulse is strong. What's this? A tattoo of the name Gus.
Gus.
This is for Jugbender.
The fuck?
Hmm.
Who the fuck's Jugbender?
She's alive and kicking. Which reminds me. Next, remove any and all weapons from the victim. We don't want her thrashing about and lopping off any more appendages.
Good thinking.
Yeah, let's start with those dangerous pants. Let's get those off. No? Fine.
Alright, I've got her sword.
Sport game.
It's engraved with a name. Dante Dragota.
Ooh, he sounds tough.
Oh my god, Winslow.
Now,
ooh, he sounds
tough.
Elevate
her feet to help with circulation.
Got it.
What? Yeah, let's get those boots. Okay.
Elevating her feet.
Did that just come out of her ass?
An assassin's ledger.
Fascinating.
Who knew bounty hunters were so meticulous?
Alright. Oh, what next on the list? That's... nice.
She still hasn't come round. A most curious case. If only we had smelling salts, that would do the trick.
Right. I guess we need to find something to... Does DeCarver have anything? Can we get something from him? Yo!
Hey, DeCarver.
Get away from me, or I'll kill you! You don't sail another man's ship simply because he left it in the harbor!
He didn't blink once then, that's creepy. Can we... Ooh, what's that? Gangplank. The fuck's a gangplank? Oh, okay. That's a gangplank. Right. Is there anything... Ah, fire the cannon! Let's blow shit up!
Narwhal's cannon. While it lacks firepower, it does look scary.
That it does, Guybrush. That it does. Quarters doors?
The Narwhal's quarters. They're resplendent.
I guess not. Can we go upstairs? No! Can we climb... Oh, can we climb up here? Yes! Awesome.
Eustachian Passage.
Okay. A wound. Gross.
I've seen my fair share of flesh wounds in this world.
Tis only a flesh wound.
A cochlea or inner ear.
I didn't click that.
I may have gone to public school, but I think those are supposed to come in pairs.
Stop cheating. I'm meant to click stuff. You're not meant to just randomly go, oh, look at that. You're ruining the experience. Stinky ear. Ooh, this might work. If it smells.
Manatee earwax. Rotten and pungent. Perfect.
Perfect. Right, let's go. Let's wake her up. How do I get off? Is it over here? No? Oh, it's okay. My ship's all backwards in this part. It's weird.
Ooh, I almost forgot. My pyrite parrot. I never leave home without it.
Don't we have it? Oh.
It must have been jostled out of my pockets and washed away during ingestion. It's gone forever.
No! Don't care. Don't care. Look, look. I'll just fill the void. It's me, Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pyro. No one likes me. Right, stinky earwax. Have a smell of this, love.
Guybrush?
Really?
Easy, Moan Adversaire. That'll teach you to take a legendary pirate at sword point.
I feel offended that she would
you lost your weapon
think privileges. Of me when smelling that.
Where are we?
We've been swallowed by a giant manatee, and you're about to pose as my fake wife in order to placate a puzzle-obsessed whack job.
Let's go!
Oh, no, I'm not. Oh. As much as I'd love to play house with the Guybrush Threepwood,
yeah,
I'm
you
already
would.
Late getting you back
yeah,
to
you would.
Island.
Listen here, you poor excuse for a pissy private here. Any more nipping are you, and the captain will be sending your carcass on a tour of the small intestine.
Winslow grew some fucking balls!
I guess we call this the good pirate, bad pirate.
Nice. Game.
Ooh, my.
It's not looking too good, though.
I think I ought to rest for a spell. Must have taken a mouthful of something vile. <later.
laughs> Yeah, I bet you've taken a mouthful of something vile.
Was, and it's in
oh,
the
Winslow.
Of the entire Caribbean.
Oh, Winslow.
Even Elaine.
Okay, fine. But you have to do something for me.
Oh, yeah.
What is it?
Will you sign this for me?
Oh.
2 seconds ago, you were ready to slit my throat, and now you want to hang me in your locker?
Women,
I was
right?
Just doing my job.
Yeah.
Give it here. Now, let's go deal with Kuki Coronado de Cava. You're my make-believe wife, so just act like it.
Yeah. So get in the What the fuck are you doing outside? Get in the fucking kitchen.
God damn.
Coronado, I'd like to introduce you to my wife, Elaine. Right. So, as you can see, there is no way I could be romantically affiliated with the voodoo lady.
Yeah.
I am a one-woman man.
Sure you are, lover boy. If you two are really just wed, you don't mind answering a few questions?
Do your worst.
Okay, she's a bit keen.
I appreciate the enthusiasm. Easy, girl.
Together now. How did you meet?
Spelunking? Pilates? We met through work.
Where did you go on your first date?
Sunken. What is that? Discotheques? That's not how you spell discotheques. The circus? The exclamation point! Goddamn! Sailing sound. Let's go to the circus.
The circus!
We went sailing!
Aww.
Alright, that's enough!
You believe us?
Almost.
Almost? What do I have to do to prove to you that I'm not your rival for the voodoo lady?
I got it wrong.
Take a step forward.
Why would you say sailing, you bint?
Both of you.
Circus is much more fun than sailing.
Now,
goddamn.
Let's get down to
apart from the clowns, barnacles. They creep me out. Aww, what? Really?
I have asked you both a series of personal questions, the answers of which are recorded here and
are we on a game show?
Mr. Threepwood,
we're on a game show.
You know that your wife has passed with flying colors. She seems to know every single detail of your life.
I'm gonna win, Morgan. I'm gonna get
now
that boat.
It's your turn. Let's see what you
I'm
know
go to
about
the Bahamas.
Mrs. Threepwood. Answer three in a row correctly, and I'll believe you are honeymooning.
This guy loves rolling his ass, doesn't he?
And it's the bowels of the beast for both of you. Question number one.
Is this because I got that question wrong?
Is her
I mean, Morgan got that
idol.
Question wrong.
That's an easy one.
What was the question again?
Could you repeat that?
Is her greatest idol.
That's an easy one.
Oh. That'd be me, wouldn't it? Guybrush Threepwood.
Guybrush Threepwood.
Correct.
Yeah.
Idol is a strong word.
Question number two. What was the name of her favorite pet?
This is for Jugbender.
Oh, right. So we were meant to pay attention to these? What was the second one?
Gomez. Not on the carpet.
Okay, it's Gomez. Gomez. Final answer. That's Gomez. There you are. Gomez!
Gomez.
Correct.
No way.
Impressive, huh?
Yeah.
The third
she's impressed.
And final question. She recently purchased a ship. This vessel is known as the Nave of Blank.
Oh, that'd be on the list, wouldn't it?
What's this? An assassin's ledger.
Fascinating.
Who knew bounty hunters were so meticulous?
Yeah. What? Let's hear the question again. It was some. Scroll up, goddammit. Hear the question again.
Could you repeat that?
She recently purchased a ship. This vessel is known
the nave
as
of...
the Nave of Blank.
Choose an answer. Jugbender?
Jugbender?
Oh, come on.
Wrong! Failure! You know nothing of this woman. She is an imposter!
Whoa!
Prepare to be digested!
What the fuck?
No. Let me try again.
Why should I?
Because you want to be sure you're not killing innocent tourists.
Yeah.
I suppose you are right. Plus, this is more excitement than I have had in years. Fine.
Let's
again.
Play Wheel of Fortune.
Question number one. What
oh, we gotta do it again.
What's the name of her first love?
Was that tattoo?
What's this? A tattoo of the name Gus.
Okay. Gustavo?
Gustavo.
Correct.
What? How did you...
Because I'm fucking
question
awesome.
Number two. She was recently affected by the death of someone very close to her. Uncle what?
Would that be Jugbender? Oh, no. I need to... Wait, let me think.
Just one second.
The list had something about a funeral, didn't it?
What's this? An assassin's
legend? Skip
legend?
To the end. Skip to the end.
Who knew bounty hunters were so meticulous?
No. I guess it might be. It must be. Jugbender. She was like, no! Jugbender! No! Jugbender.
Jugbender.
Correct.
Okay.
How?
The third and final question.
The third.
She is quite a skilled fighter. Who trained her in the ways of combat?
That be a sword? Name on a sword?
It's engraved with a name. Dante Dragotto.
Right.
Ooh, he sounds...
God damn it, Winslow. God damn it. Right. Dante Dragotto.
Dante Dragotto.
Correct. Well, perhaps I was mistaken.
Yeah,
you two might
perhaps.
Be married after all.
Yeah.
No, it's all right. If a guy turns up in a manatee with your girlfriend's locket, a man has a right to ask a question or two. Now, about this sponge.
The one you're not after?
We're just sightseeing, right, honey?
That's right, Pookie Pie.
Really?
Perhaps you would like to join my crew. It could make a romantic tale for your honeymoon scrapbook.
I'd love to join your crew. I'm gaga for scrapbooking. We'll find La Esponja Grande in no time.
Yeah!
Magnifico!
What's next? A stool sample?
No, you Breaks. Look like a man of firm constitution. Now, any questions?
Right, I'm going to end this part off right here. And we will carry on next time. So I'll see you next time, guys. And thanks for watching.